In this video, we're analyzing the impact of a dart with a block. Then the dart and block combination compresses a spring to its maximum compression distance. And this setup can actually be used to measure the initial velocity of the dart based on the maximum compression of the spring. And that's the point of the problem. We're going to work through the collision backwards from the maximum compression of the spring all the way back to the initial speed of the dart. So in part A, we're asked to compute the speed of the combined masses just after the impact. In other words, we're comparing the second picture to the third picture. And working our way backwards, we have the maximum compression of that spring storing spring potential energy. That came from the kinetic energy of the combined masses after the impact being converted into spring potential energy. And we'll go ahead and call that velocity V. So energy is conserved in this part of the process. And in my initial state, I have the kinetic energy of the combined masses. I'll call that 1/2, little m for the dart, big M for the block. So m plus m times V squared. That's all converted into the spring potential energy at the maximum compression. So that's 1/2 kx squared. The 1/2s cancel here. And I can divide by m plus m on both sides and square root the result to solve for the velocity of those combined masses as the compression process begins. So I find that V is the square root of kx squared divided by the sum of the two masses, little m plus big M. So it's time to put in the numbers. And we were told the spring constant was 10 newtons per meter. The maximum compression was 3.8 centimeters, which needs to be converted to meters, so that's 0.038. Remember to square that. And then the sum of the two masses, well, that's 30 grams for the dart and 100 grams for the block. So 130 grams, or 0.130 kilograms. When we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 0.333 meters per second for the velocity of the combined masses after the impact has occurred. Next, we want to compute the speed of the dart before the impact occurred. So the key physical point here is to realize that we had an inelastic collision between the dart and the block. And provided that we don't have too much compression of the spring happening yet during the collision itself, the momentum is going to be conserved during this collision. And that's a really good approximation. The collision should happen very rapidly before the spring starts to compress and exert a force on the combined masses. So if I call the first picture state number one for the system, I could express this as P1 is equal to P2. The momentum in state one is equal to the momentum in state two. Keep in mind that energy is lost in an inelastic collision. So a common mistake you could make in this problem is comparing the energy in state two or three to the energy in state one. Energy is not conserved in that inelastic collision, so it's not going to work out. So our physical handle on things is that the momentum is conserved, and I can say in state one, the little m, the mass of the dart, times V naught, the initial velocity of the dart, that's all the momentum in the system in that state. That's going to be equal to the momentum in the final state, where the masses are combined into little m plus big M with a velocity of V that we computed in part A. So now we can just solve for V naught, the initial velocity of the dart, and that's little m plus big M, the combined masses, times the speed after the collision over little m, the mass of the dart. And it's time to plug in the numbers. Remember, the combined masses was a total of 130 grams or 0.130 kilograms. Then the mass of the dart, that's 0.030 kilograms. And the speed of the combined masses after the collision, we computed that in part A, 0.333 meters per second. When we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 1.44 meters per second for the initial velocity of the dart. Finally, we're asked to compute the energy lost in the collision. And the reason I put this on this test question was to remind everybody that energy is lost in the collision. So I was trying to help the students avoid the mistake of comparing the initial energy to the final energy. You're going to see a loss of energy in that inelastic collision. So all we have to do to answer the question is compute the initial kinetic energy. That's 1/2 little m V naught squared. So the mass of the dart, 0.030. Initial velocity of the dart squared, so 1.44 meters per second, all squared. And when we run the numbers, we get 0.0311 joules. Then we compute the final energy. And you have a choice here. We could compute the final energy as the kinetic energy of the combined masses before the spring compresses, or we could use the energy stored in the spring at maximum compression. Remember, the spring compression process is energy conserving, so either one of those is going to give the same answer. I'm going to go ahead and use the kinetic energy immediately after the collision. So our combined masses were 0.130 kilograms, the speed just after the impact, 0.333 meters per second. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 0.0072 joules. So how much was lost? You just take the difference between the initial kinetic energy and the final kinetic energy. And this turns out to be 0.0239 joules. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.